Hey, what up, America? It's your boy, Bhushan Glover, Better Black America TV on YouTube, and you have just tuned in to A Better Black America This Week. Now, today is Saturday, November 23rd, 2019. Now, this week in Better Black America This Week, we're going to deal with the, talk about the impeachment hearings and basically the plan moving forward. We're going to have to start dealing with the truth, because the truth shall make us free. So let's go ahead and get right on into it. Now, the impeachment hearings of Donald J. Trump. Now, and I personally watched the impeachment hearings, and, you know, for me personally, you know, it's not about me. It's about the big picture. In my personal opinion, when I watched the impeachment hearings, you know, because I'm not Republican or Democrat, so therefore, my mindset is basically from a judge perspective, from looking at it from a judge perspective. And Adam Schiff, the person who's running the impeachment hearings, the congressman from California, he is a federal, former federal prosecutor. So he's prosecuting the case in the court of public opinion, which is okay. Totally understand that. But the rules are not the same when you're dealing with the court of law, because the scales of justice are supposed to be fair and imbalanced. So if you look at the scales of justice, she's blindfolded and the both sides are pretty much equal. But this one here, Adam Schiff, he's basically the, I would say, the prosecutor as well as the judge, because he sets the rules. Now, the polls, you know, if you look at mainstream media, if you look at any type of news, the polls are pretty much has not changed based on the impeachment inquiries. Now, to impeach a president, there has to be some type of quid pro quo, meaning this for that, meaning I'll give you this if you do this for me. There has to be high crimes or misdemeanors, that's proven. And there has to be something more than just not liking the sitting president. Now, these impeachment hearings, I recorded them, I watched them, because, you know, moving forward, we have to really understand what we have to do as Black America moving forward. Now, when I say Black America, you know, when you look at the Democratic Party, the Democratic Party has pretty much turned into a party that's greatly divided. And if you saw the debates this week, and we'll just expound on that just a little bit, you know, there's like 13 candidates on the stage, and everyone has their own disposition. Everyone has their own agenda when it comes to, you know, where do they see America moving forward. But the Democratic Party as a whole, you know, is basically, I wouldn't say in shambles right now, but is basically looking for its identity. And Barack Obama himself had to come out and make a statement. And he stated that, you know, if you have an issue, instead of, you know, tearing down something and creating and then trying to make something new, why don't you just improve what we already have? Which I totally agree. Okay, because without a shadow of a doubt, Barack Obama was the only sitting president that the Black America came out and supported, and he received 97% of the vote. And I believe that's on both terms. But moving forward, I talk to people on a daily basis, and you know, and no one has a candidate that they can actually say that that's who they're voting for. Even the Bernie Sanders movement during the 2016 election, they're confused now because of his health issues, and he keeps saying the same thing. Like, he could only say, you know, the top 1% owns the 1% of the wealth, and, you know, and he's pushing a socialist narrative, but America has never been a socialist society. America is a republic that practices democracy. And to be honest with you, democracy has nothing to do with being democratic. Democracy, by definition, basically allow the people to push bills and laws in terms of voting for these bills and laws. And it, a pure democracy, there's no checks and balances. It would basically be the people voting amongst the people and force and basically put into law what the people want, and the republic has to support that. Now, to my understanding, they do not do the Pledge of Allegiance in some certain schools, and it was a democratic push because they did not want the new generations to understand that America is a republic. Because when you say the Pledge of Allegiance, it's to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God. So America is a God-fearing republic, which by definition means supreme power. So the Democrats basically separated from the party because they wanted to preserve slavery. And that we'll get to that on another date. But these impeachment hearings. Now, did the president commit a crime? Did the president do something that's damaging to America that any other president has not done? Their biggest witness, and this is the truth, their biggest witness basically overheard on a phone call about the president asking about an investigation. But no one has said that it was, you know, for the investigation of the Bidens or whatever the case is. But politics is dirty. And as Americans, we do know that. So you're going to have to bend the rules to basically get what you want and how you want it. But did the president commit an impeachable crime? Now, we could go back to the Clintons because, you know, in recent years, that's the only impeachment example or sample size that we can actually use right now is, you know, the Monica Lewinsky. Now, was that abuse of power for the president of the United States of America to basically have sexual relations with an intern? Now, and I've been in supervisory positions, and it was pretty much against the rules to either date or to have sex or to show favoritism to subordinates, meaning people that you supervise. And I was just on a, you know, on a, you know, it wasn't a grand scale, but it was pretty much on a high level of security. But when you're talking about the president of the United States, who's basically the most powerful human being on the planet while in office and pretty much having sex, you know, with an intern, I wouldn't say that's abuse of power, but it was bipartisan agreement that he had to go to the through the impeachment process because he actually lied about it. But then they came up with the blue dress. But America, what are we going to do moving forward? And I'm pretty much calling out Black America because with the impeachment hearings, they pretty much don't like the moral compass of a president and they don't like a non-career politician to have access to the classified information. Now, there's an old saying, he who laughs last, laughs best. Now, Trump already basically gave us a little snippet of what's to come because he's going to start dropping dimes and jewels on that Democratic Party. So therefore, we're pretty much in a civil war. So the last civil war was basically the Southern Confederate Democrats wanting to preserve slavery, wanting my people, myself, my ancestors to not be human and to be classified as three-fifths as property in the sense of free labor, like a donkey or a mule, which is their mascot. They wanted free labor, but the Union, the North, wanted to preserve capitalism because it was not fair for people to have to be enslaved to actually for profit, you know, pretty much like our with our private prisons corporations. But we're going to do another video down the road talking about that because we found the link between the private prison organizations and the record label. And this is why they're pushing this, you know, this music. I got black, I got white, what you want. Basically, I got heroin, I got cocaine, what you want. So they're pretty much trying to create a society of a revolving door that continues to put people in prison so they can capitalize from a Wall Street perspective because these private prisons trade on Wall Street. But the impeachment hearings, this is a civil war. Adam Schiff, you know, he does not like the president. You know, a lot of the pretty much the Democratic Party as a whole does not like the president, but they're blocking the advancement of Black America because of it keeps us oppressed. So therefore, we were Republican in the beginning because Abraham Lincoln, Republican president, signed the Emancipation Proclamation. Frederick Douglass, the abolitionist, was a part of the abolitionist movement, was a Republican. And our first nine congressmen from North and South Carolina were in the House of Congress, and they were Black from North and South Carolina as Republicans. And the reason it changed, because the Ku Klux Klan by force, forced Southern Blacks to vote Democratic or they would die. Sean Puffy Combs did not come up with vote or die when we were buying those Barack Obama t-shirts. It was the Ku Klux Klan post-Civil War by force. So if you look at the Democratic Party, oppresses Black America. And I'm going to say this again, the Democratic Party oppresses Black America. And this is the fact that I have to say this is, you know, I have to say. Now, when Lyndon B. Johnson signed the Civil Rights Act, it was supposed to be for the civil and the justice and the equality for the Black race, but they decided to add everybody, including animals, into that civil rights bill. And when you look at it today, we are still behind the eight ball. Because I dare you to talk to a white Democratic feminist about the Black movement. I dare you to talk to a white gay male about Black empowerment. I dare you. So identity politics has basically pushed us out, and it has forced us to think and to come up with a plan of what we're going to do to move forward. And that plan is to be nonpartisan independent with our own narrative moving forward. Now, freedom is one thing. Now, if you look up the definition of independent, it's freedom. And if you look at the definition of oppression, basically, it's a prolonged, cruel, or unjust treatment of control. Prolonged. So time's up. So it's time for us to be free and independent when it comes to voting, because Black America is pretty much the strongest voting bloc, and both sides should be fighting for our vote, but we don't have a plan. We do not have any unity. But we're going to talk about this moving forward. So stay tuned, and we're going to keep pushing this narrative. We're not going anywhere. The podcast is on its way, A Better Black America Podcast. We're going to just keep on pushing this agenda because the truth shall make us free. Now, Kamala Harris stated, you know, in the watching the impeachment hearings, there was pretty much Democrats were saying that Donald Trump got played by Russia. And Kamala Harris is on record and all in my Facebook timeline, Donald Trump got played by Russia. Have to be honest with you. Black America got played by the Democrats. Okay? Black America got played by the Democrats. And I'm going to challenge you. You know, one of my favorite rappers is 2 Chainz. And he spits a different type of lingo. He plays on words. So it might take 2 to 3 times to listen to understand what he's talking about. So I challenge you to go back, listen to this video. You know, not once, maybe 2 or 3 times, and pull some nuggets or some things of concern yourself, and you go and do the research so you can actually understand the direction of what we need to do moving forward, because it's about survival at this point. And the identity politics, like I said, has ruined the Democratic Party for Black America, because we still have not got our justice from a social and economic perspective. So independence is our only way to go. And I know that, you know, our ancestors went through slavery, but pretty much this is our time and this is our moment, because you have to go back and watch the 400-year anniversary video. And August 20th of this year, 2019, commemorated the 400-year anniversary of the biblical principle of the 400-year curse. And now we're going into 2020, which pretty much is clear vision. Now, 2020 represents clear vision. So look at the timing. And these are our receipts. So when people say, what are you talking about? We got receipts. We got numbers, we got times and dates to justify as to why we have to do this as a people. Now, the Democratic Party is divided. The Republican Party is united. And that's the difference. So can they win these these electoral college votes, or they will be happy just winning a general election? Now, the Electoral College, and I'll do a video on that, is very important, because if there was no Electoral College, Kanye West and Kim Kardashian could become president and vice president because of the popularity of what's going on, because that Jesus is King album is number one on the Billboard 200. So that's a sign for Blacks, for us God-fearing Christians. But I could go on and on and on. But it's time to do what's right. You know, it's time for us to look in that mirror and try to think of ways where Black America fell off. We know where we fell off, but come to an understanding of where we need to be, because we are divided. I hear it all the time. We'll never get together. Black folk, okay, with that type of attitude, we won't, but we can't and we will. But I'm going to keep it, go ahead and keep it short, keep it 15 minutes. And with that being said, man, hey, enjoy your Saturday. This your boy Bhushan Glover, a better Black America, and more importantly, a better America for all. With that being said, enjoy your Saturday. Have a great day. A Better Black America TV on YouTube. Peace out.